You could land a six-figure data analytics job in 3 months, right? That's what you get to hear on all the LinkedIn posts, all, you know, Insta stories. But what if I told you that's not the actual story? I mean, there is something behind it. In today's video, we are going to actually deep dive into all the non-talking elements of the data analytics, which has been not in the talk for lately. Hey everyone, I am Shubhrajit Basu, and I have almost close to 9 years of data analytics experience. I have worked with multiple companies, including Flipkart. And from my experience, we are going to talk about the backside story of data analytics. And to be very frank, this is not to scare you. This is to give you the full idea of what data analytics is, and you should choose it or not. Okay, so that's how we are going to talk about it. You know, to jump into a data analytics career, or you're already in the process of getting into a data analytics, or maybe you are working as a data analyst, then watch till the end to see if this career truly fits you or if another path might be a better for you. So here are some points that, you know, gonna help you to decide whether the data analytics is really suit for you or not. Okay, the first one, let's talk about the job market of the data analytics. You know, every day almost we see a lot of data analytics post jobs and everything, but how much that actually grown up? Let's be real, you know, every day hundreds of people are actually completing all the data analytics courses, boot camps, YouTube playlist. But what about the job? Like, how many job postings are there? I mean, in my career, I have seen in the LinkedIn also that for one single job post, there are then more than 1,000 people are applying for that. So this is that much of crunches. Now the real question is, you know, has the job market has grown in the data analytics industry? The answer is yes, it has grown. But what about the candidate? Also, it has grown to a huge number. Now, if I have to talk about a number quickly, a recent study, I think by LinkedIn, I think it's done on 2025 quarter one, if I'm not wrong, or maybe 2024, end of 2024, it shows that the job market has grown by only 24%, whereas the candidate, the entire base of our data analysts, grown by 184%. So you can see the ratios, which is really a very less for a very huge number of people. Now, the second point is learning curve, right? When I started back in 2016-17, I think that time, it was only an Excel. Like, I think from that onwards, we started adding SQL, and then there are things like Tableau, then Power BI, and then Python. Now, in the era of AI in 2025, this is not only limited to all these five tools, there are more, right? You need to know, for example, you need to know all the AI tools, you need to know machine learning basics, you need to know statistics, because with the growing trends in the industry and the changing dynamics, need to know skill is a very important factor. Tools like DBT, Snowflakes, Looker are now the baseline expectations, and all thanks to the AI. Even a survey done by the Indian Analytics Magazine in 2023, it says that almost 62% of analysts are actually, you know, it's very said that it's very difficult to cope up with this learning curve. So make sure that you are on top of your learning. The third point, I think one of the important factor is to upskilling, right? Continuous upskilling is needed if you are into data analytics. I think before 2020, or on the time of till 2020, it was only Excel and basic of SQL. But after 2021, 2022, it was, you know, Excel, SQL, and Python. Or maybe you could say Excel, SQL, and Tableau. Or we can add Power BI. I think back in 2023, 2024, it was like Python, Power BI, Excel, SQL, statistics. And in 2025, if I have to add for this year, this would be like ChatGPT, Copilot, and all the things are releasing right now. And you need to learn, you need to upgrade up skills every single day. A recent study by Gartner has done, I think once the AI era started, that by the year of 2026, almost 40% jobs would go away for data analytics. And that was due to the automations done by the AIs and tools. And we have already started seeing, you know, all the layoffs in different industries, fields and all, that can impact the entire universe of analytics. The fourth point would be the work-life balance. Now, I think this is one of the major in town kind of thing. I would say if you open a LinkedIn, you see this kind of talk always happening about the work-life balance. But if I have to talk about specifically about the data analytics, then I would say that data analyst, you know, has less work-life balance. For example, I worked in Flipkart, I worked in a lot of other companies, and what I've seen that there are requirements suddenly on the weekends, there are requirements suddenly on at night, because there is a data need or the analysis needed the next day to present that to the business. And the entire business actually held up just because of your analysis. So you cannot expect to have a very good data, like very good life, work-life balance. If you compare with other field, like if I compare with the product management, if I compare with the UX design, and if you look at the Glassdoor rating of, you know, the work-life balance for data analyst to compare to UX design and maybe product manager, I think data analyst stand for 3.4 and out of 5, whereas the other UX designer especially stand in 3.8, the product manager stands for almost 3.6. So you see there is a gap of data, you know, work-life balance. And if you're looking for something as stable, does not have much of a, you know, ups and downs in every single day or week, then data analysis is not a field for you. Okay. And the last but not least, one of the very important point I really want to talk about, if you are a fresher, if you're listening to this and if you're just planning out your data analytics journey, then this is very, very important. This point is that the social media versus the reality. Like if you open an Insta reel, if you open an Insta page, YouTube ad, LinkedIn post, you see what? You see that in a 3 months, you can become a huge data analyst, can earn 24 LP, right? One of the very prominent ad you might have seen definitely is that workshops for 99 rupees in 3 hours and you get a job of 40 LP. Let me tell you, this is absolutely wrong and this is just a marketing gimmick. It takes a good amount of time. If I have to define that time, maybe in another video I can explain you the roadmap of that, but it takes at least 6 to 12 months to get from 0 to 1 in data analytics. Like from learning to get a job, it takes a time. So put that time and don't, you know, think through all these ads and reels that I know you can do that in 1 or 2 months. The people you are seeing, for example, if you see someone who got a double salary in 3 months, but you don't see the back end effort they have done, like, you know, maybe they have done 1,000 hours or 100 hours of studying, doing coding, all these things. This is one of the important factors. So thank you very much for watching, and this is me, Shubhrajit Basu, signing off for today. And please do like, share and subscribe my channel Analytics Everywhere. It would be a encouragement for me to make such content and, you know, help you get into this kind of data related content. And again, thank you very much. Do subscribe Analytics Everywhere.